calibration stuff. So now I have actually played part of this game before. We are gonna get, my face is gonna get like blacked out. Hopefully it won't happen too much. I love the look of this. So I have played some of this before, so I'm actually working on, we're gonna do the second level. So there's two levels available right now in the early access. We're gonna do the second one because I've actually played the first one back when it was still in its academic version. Definitely interested in seeing, of course, what it looks like in the new state, but I want to showcase kind of the newer one and showcase one I've never done, so it kind of adds to the piece of it. Oh, my sensitivity. We appreciate you arriving extra early today. So yeah, so a little kind of background and basics of the game here with it. What you are essentially working as is you are a neuroprober, which means you are jumping into the minds of people who are having either psychotic issues or psychiatric issues. And what you're trying to do is you're trying to figure out what exactly happened to them, basically put the pieces of their life together, so to speak, and try to find a decent solution. One second here, guys. I'm just going to try to get a little extra light in here. And try to figure out what actually happened. So it's a bit of a puzzle-style game, but what the neat part of it behind it is the biofeedback entity, which you can't see because it's, of course, underneath my clothes here, but I am wearing a Garmin chest strap, which will actually measure and test my heartbeat variability, which is used to help test your level of unease, fear, etc., and the game changes based on that. So hopefully I'll get a good chance to show you some of that. Yep, see, it even notices I'm wearing it. Cool. I may have to cut down the mouse sensitivity. My goodness, my mouse is flying over. Okay, I don't know which way I'm supposed to go anymore. Ah, that's right, okay. I actually don't really remember where I'm supposed to go now. Okay, at this point, ah, here we go, that's right. That's right, you get your own little office. Isn't that cool? Dr. Alex Schwartz, hell yeah. Don't I feel special? I do like how they have this whole thing set up. All right, so we've got a train sim, which kind of explains how the game works and whatnot. If you get your own, I highly recommend you do that first, obviously. Process complete. Oh, I thought they were supposed to have... Wait a second, they're supposed to be, oh, maybe train sim and the other level is the same? I don't know, no. I was thinking... Patient imprint processing incomplete, okay. Okay, I guess I was wrong. I can only do it through the tutorial part of it. That's good. I've actually never done the whole tutorial, so... This would be a good way to show everything anyways. I love this.
Things have become almost unbearable for me and for my family. Nothing has helped. I guess that's why I'm here. So, if I just talk about my troubles, you'll be able to use it later to help with the procedure? Seems hard to believe, but you're the experts. I think many of my issues started when I was young. So why don't we start with my childhood days, yes? Okay, let's see. I was raised in a lovely cottage in rural Germany.
We didn't
have much, but my twin sister, our father, and I got by. There was actually a great famine for much of my early childhood, and often we went without food. I had many
happy moments. That does sound almost similar
to
me. I never thought of that.
The darkest times began when my father remarried. My stepmother always resented my sister and me. We didn't like her much either, to be honest. God, she was horrible.
That's such a mean thing to say.
Sometimes, she would take my sister and me out for long walks in the forest, and then she'd hurry home. My sister and I couldn't keep up, and we'd often get lost. We learned to leave a trail of whatever we could find on those walks to help us get home. I guess in some ways, our stepmother helped us become resourceful like that. My sister is a real fighter, the kind of woman any girl or boy could look up to. She volunteers to work with various youth organizations now. Enough about her. Okay, what else? Maybe I should talk about my
right.
feelings. Yes? You may find it hard to believe, but I've always struggled with various eating disorders and anxiety around food. Eating anything rich makes me feel scared and anxious.
That looks delicious.
It's hard
though.
To describe. My sister has actually experienced similar issues, and it's worsened for us both as we've gotten older. That's not normal, now is it? We've seen countless doctors about this in the past. They've determined that our issues may be trauma-related, but have yet to help us sort out the underlying source. They have yet to fix us. And that's why we're here.
So, for all the new people that just popped into the stream, guys, welcome to the stream. We are live streaming here Nevermind, which was done by Flying Mollusk. This is a biofeedback-enhanced horror game. So you can't see it, obviously, because it's underneath my clothes, but I am wearing a Garmin Chest Strap heart monitor hooked up to the computer, so it can actually sense my heartbeat variability. And what you'll see throughout the game is it does possibly change things. One of the things I have turned on that I'm realizing is covered up on my own logo a little bit. So give me one second, guys. I'm going to move. There we go. Going to move the logo so you guys can see the little fear interface piece up in the top left corner there. There's a little heartbeat that's glowing. That's letting you know that it's actually sensing the heartbeat and lets you kind of know this, what they call their fear UI. And so what we just saw there was kind of the idea behind the patient telling us what's wrong in their life, what they're thinking, what they've been experiencing. And so now we play the part of kind of jumping into it. So this position I'm in right now is basically a training simulator that they're meant to kind of get used to the game. So it'll walk you through a lot of the features. Let me know if I start going too fast or if you want to see something with it. Since I know a bit about the game, it's obviously going to be a bit quicker for me.
Welcome to NeuroProber Training. I am pleased to be your guide. When I'm speaking, you can always make a right-click motion to skip this instruction.
Notice
whether you're speaking with a client directly or neuroprobing within their mind, it is always imperative to listen. You'll find that every detail of the subconscious is trying to tell its story. In the case of our clients, it's often the forgotten story of the trauma they experience. Some parts of the patient's memory may have become confused or corrupted by the conscious mind's attempts to reconcile or cover up the truth of what happened to them. However, if you look closely and carefully in the right places, you'll find that the truth will ultimately shine through.
And so, of course, that's what we're trying to do.
Some parts of the subconscious allow you to interact with them. While neuroprobing, make a left-click motion to engage with it. Holding on to right-click will allow you to move the item around to examine it further. When you are done, you can make a left-click motion again, and it will return to its natural position.
That's actually kind of cool. Makes me kind of hungry. But the fact that it's on the ground, I guess, I don't know.
While neuroprobing, you will encounter objects that look like photographs. This is how your consciousness interprets the concrete memory moments it finds within the client's psyche. Typically, there are about 10 of these memory photos found in each psyche. The mind can only hold on to so much. You'll find that half of these photos present an actual moment relating to the trauma. The other half tend to be false memories created by the client's conscious mind. It will ultimately be up to you to determine which are which. More on that later.
So that's where the puzzle aspect of the game essentially comes into play. You do that and absorbs into it, and it goes up in these little walls here. And then later you have to try to put together the actual items based on what you discovered throughout.
When you acknowledge a memory photo, it will surface more prominently in the client's psyche and, at that point, can be found in a safe area of the mind, often where you begin within the client's mind. When you have found all 10 photos, you must put 5 of the memories that actually represent the trauma in the proper order. Doing so will, at last, fully release the memory to the client's conscious mind. Often, he or she will experience a breakthrough at this moment. That breakthrough is what every neuroprober lives for, and is the key to the client finally being able to work towards true recovery.
So as you guys can kind of see now, there's a little bit of static forming up on the screen. So that's part of that fear interface kind of piece of it. The game will talk a little bit more about it. Unfortunately for me, it does heartbeat variability, and I'm kind of excited about playing this. So I'm kind of screwing the system a little bit by accident.
The most important thing you do as a neuroprober is find and acknowledge these photos. However, this is easier said than done. While some photos are freely available in the subconscious, others are buried deeply within and will need to be coaxed out.
Dear brats, go away. Well, that's just not nice. I love the irony of love your stepmom at the end of that. if there's another one hiding around here or not. Pretty flower. Oh, that's okay. It does talk about that. I thought I did. This is an important point, too.
Interacting with one part of the mind can sometimes open up new areas of the psyche. Some things, like these doors, can change their state in response to actions taken elsewhere.
Sister, save me from becoming dinner. God, I hope that's not part of the real memory. I love the atmospheric design.
Have you noticed the world can sometimes become fuzzy and degraded, like static on a television? That's the client's subconscious mind reacting to your own feelings of fear, stress, and anxiety. The subconscious doesn't take kindly to intruders, and will take every opportunity to feed off of any sensations of anxiety or tension you offer to it. If you can, try to stay calm and peaceful, even in the face of the terror. If you can calm yourself, you'll find the subconscious will calm itself too.
And that's where, of course, the biofeedback comes into play.
Here is an example of an especially buried memory. Some details of a given trauma can be especially tenacious, but by gently and cleverly listening to the clues the mind gives you, you will find all you need to work through it. Just think of it as a puzzle for you to solve. When you focus on these puzzles, make a right-click motion if you need to break your concentration.
I do like how they take all these ideas of basically standard gameplay mechanics, so you want to have a puzzle or something to achieve, and they fit it into the idea of this mind. Yeah, Gun, I'm not much better, so this will be interesting to see how it works later. Oh, I have to remember how to do this one again. Where do I put the rock? Oh, you can put it in the bird's mouth. Let me get that last one to go away. Oh, are some of these heavier than other ones? Oh, okay. Actually, that one's not in the way, so I'm gonna leave that one where it is. Very missed, yeah, right? There doesn't do me any good. Can't put it there. That doesn't do me any good. I'm so bad at this. Alright, I'm feeling very stupid that I can't think of this puzzle right now. What am I doing wrong? Doesn't seem to do anything. I feel like there's other branches I can't move, which is why I'm kind of confused. Unless those are attached to that? I don't know. Right? Wow, I'm feeling like such a noob right now that I can't figure it out. I know I figured this out at one point, which is why it's bothering me all the more. Doesn't seem to do me any good. Is there somewhere else I can put? No, there really isn't. Okay, it's gotta be one, like, I think there's only so many combinations I can do here. just covers it up more. Alright, now that everybody's probably laughing at me in streams, I'm trying to figure this out. I don't remember it being this hard before. Not that, like, I almost feel like that should be it, because, like, it looks like it's almost all been covered. Unless there's, like, there's more to, I don't know. Am I just retarded here? I feel like that looks like it should be it almost, but I can't move those, so what can I... That's definitely not right. Oh, this is just sad now. Okay, what am I doing wrong here, guys? Do they have to be in a certain order I have to do this in? That could be, actually. I didn't think about that. Okay, let me reset it once here. If we do... No, that doesn't seem any good. Let's put this one over here. The fail is real here, guys. Like I know I figured it out earlier, which is why this is bugging me even more. I can't put one here at all, can I? No. Oh my god. Okay, I gotta be thinking something wrong here. I mean, it matches their eyes too, which is why I was kind of thinking that might be right. Wait a second. Is that... No, that's... Okay, that's not what I want to do. Yeah, that's just more in the way. Now I feel like I'm missing a part of the puzzle or something. I just throw this rock at it. Okay, what the heck am I? I could have sworn that was the solution too from before, which is like all the real reason why I'm like, what the heck? Is there somewhere else I can put these? Doesn't seem like it. Putting them in the hands doesn't lower them anyways. That's what I'm guessing? That's kind of what I thought, but I don't know now. There's no way to move that last one, which is why it doesn't make any sense that if it has to be all clear in the middle. Give something similar. Oh, of course, the developer telling me what I'm doing wrong. Is there a third stone that I just missed then? Hold on. Okay, let me reset to what it was before. Yeah, that's what I was thinking too, but I don't. If there is another stone, I'm not seeing it, and it's feeling really stupid if I don't see it now. Is there another stone? Oops, wrong button. Sorry. It's not hiding around here, is it now? Failing the first puzzle, guys, it's just sad. Oh, it is. Aha, there is another stone there. You just can't see it. Alright, guys, I'm going home. Oh, my lord. That was way harder than it should have been. That is my bad, guys. Ay, ay, ay. I say, I'm like sitting here going, I could have sworn there was three stones too, because I'd done this, I did a lot of this partially before, so I wouldn't look like a total noob on stream, and then, yeah, of course, that would be the way things would happen for me. Oh my goodness. Yeah, right? I don't know if I'm back. I might have my brightness settings set a little too low than if that's showing up that way. Jeez. Okay, door slamming should not freak me out that much, but it kind of does. Now I have no idea where I'm going. Oh, I see a fence open. Oh, yeah, that's not creepy. Oh my god. Yeah, that's not creepy at all, guys. Totally not. Oh, lord. I'm waiting for one of them to fall on me or something. I knew it was going to happen, too. I knew it was going to happen. It still freaked me out. Can I pick it up? I want to pick up the baby's head. I see a picture. Oh, but I can't. Nah. There we go, gotta go run around. Nope. Right, Adrian? Never mind, just leave. Now you know where the game name comes from. A terrible fire burned our home down. Well, that's just... You know, the best thing about this game, guys, is just how uplifting and everything else. Oh my god. Alright. Calming myself down a bit. God, this is worse than me trying to play Outlast, I swear. What does this thing say?
While neuroprobing, your consciousness is lost deep inside the subconscious mind of the client. While this is a journey that you must make alone, we at the Neurostalgia Institute take the safety of our neuroprobers very seriously. If you need to access any of your neuroprober tools or pull your consciousness free, press your finger where an escape key might be. This will bring up your neuroprober tools, and you can proceed as needed from there.
I like that phrasing. Where an escape key might be. Oh my goodness, okay. Calm down. I always worry every time I shift in place that the sensor's moving around too on me. I thought I saw another picture over here. Maybe not. Oh, maybe I just saw a door. Was that the door I came in from? I don't remember if that's the door I came in from or not. Looks like it's similar. Oh, it's the third door over here, okay. I didn't notice that. Hey, BRC, welcome to the stream, man. Aha, that other door opened this time, okay. So as you guys can see, as I was kind of talking about earlier, all those photos we found now, You can see all these different photos appear up in the screen. Like, I'm reaching towards the screen, like you can see my hand. you can see all the different photos now that come in. So as you can see, there are 10 total. We got to try to put them into sequence towards the end of it. So part of what's kind of interesting is trying to figure out what actually happened, and some of it's kind of logic, some of it's other pieces as well. My sensor's going crazy right now. Like I said, I'm also excited about the game, which is just part of what makes this not fair. Sensor's gonna go crazy because I'm sitting here like going, I've been wanting to play this forever. Alright, let's see what opens up in here. What is my sensor showing I'm at anyways? I'm curious. Oh, okay. Not that bad. I'm afraid to show you guys the numbers. You guys don't need to see my out of shapeness.
Do you remember how I mentioned that the client's subconsciousness can feed off of your fear? Some especially vulnerable areas can be very sensitive and dangerous. When you place your consciousness in another's subconsciousness, there is a risk of you getting hurt, of the pain and the turmoil of the client's subconscious drawing your own mind into its agony. You must brave these areas despite the risks. You must stay calm. Should you let your fears get the best of you, it will be incredibly difficult to proceed unharmed.
This is why I don't tend to play horror games. Hey, Dad, thanks for the host, man. Welcome to everybody else. Welcome to all the people new for the stream, guys. Appreciate everybody popping in here. If you are kind of new to the stream and don't know what we're doing here with it, this is a really interesting game that just entered early access, as Adrian asks. So this game is called Nevermind. It is a biofeedback-enhanced horror adventure game, this kind of description used. It's by the brilliant minds of Flying Mollusk. And essentially, the premise of the game is that you take the place of a neuroprober, which is someone that dives into the subconscious minds of people who have either experienced some sort of psychiatric trauma or some sort of mental issue, maybe having post-traumatic stress disorder. There's a bunch of different scenarios that could come into play. But you basically take the job of somebody trying to investigate the inner turmoils of their mind, the inner quarters of their mind, and try to figure out what exactly happened, piece the pieces together. What makes this game extremely unique, beyond just honestly the awesome artistic design and everything else that I've loved about it so far, is the biofeedback enhanced. So you guys can't see it, but I'm wearing a Garmin heart monitor chest strap right now that's hooked up through an ANT Plus system that is actually sensing my heartbeat variability. So as you get scared, and I'm intentionally kind of moving a lot to try to show you the static here. So as you get scared, your heartbeat changes and you get the static effect. The game can change a little bit with it and it can kind of help extra scare you. And the whole premise behind it is that the game, alongside the puzzle features of it, is also yourself. You are part of the game. You're trying to keep yourself calm, focused, collect, and not, you know, scare yourself silly as you're trying to play through it. So it's a very neat game with it. We've actually been following the development of this game for a very long time. This was actually one of the first games I looked into. The developer of this, Erin Reynolds, is the first person I ever interviewed with UGE. Wonderful person, wonderful individual. You can check her out on our Indie Spotlight as well. But it's just, it's a very cool game. It's a very unique concept. The concept itself is very crazy awesome. But beyond that, they just did a really great job. It's very kind of, yeah, I know. Like I said, I was intentionally trying to get it to amp up a little bit, and so I'm trying to relax myself again now. But they really have done a great job with it. I had the interesting take of playing the academic version early, which had, you know, much simpler graphics, same concept, but the graphics have definitely been amped up quite a bit, and I am slightly kissing up because I know she's watching the stream, but I do mean what I'm saying with it, though. It is very, very neat with it, but here's the best part for everyone currently watching the stream, guys. I have even better news than just watching me play this. We do have some copies to give away. And so throughout the stream here, I am going to give away some copies. I do want to get through this first little part before I start it. So if you're interested in trying out this game yourself, stay tuned, stick around in the stream, and we will do a giveaway later with that. All right, now I'm going to try to get myself back down to a normal heartbeat. I can't even see anything anyways. Yeah, and yeah, it is definitely a vicious cycle. You get yourself scared, makes it harder. All right, there we go. Equalizing myself a bit. Which, by the way, Erin, I do appreciate you popping into the stream. I'm assuming that's you based on your name, but I could be wrong. It could be someone else using that tag. No?
Karen, you can even pick up and walk around with some objects. To do so, interact with it and then start walking while holding on to it.
Simple enough. Like something's gonna happen. I'm here. I don't want something to happen. Oops. as I clicked like an idiot. Oh, where'd it go? I think the item disappeared. Wait a second here. Oh no, okay, I got put back. I'm like, on. Wait a minute. Oops. It won't let me, like, put it on there. Oh, okay, there we go. Ah-ha-ha, there we go. Duh. Oh, that's not cool. You guys are mean. Oh my god. I'm seriously regretting having my Bose headphones on right now. I don't remember a bridge being here. Oh, that's just... That's not creepy. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Why is that there? Why? Sure. Adrian, so I can't necessarily show it to you, mostly because of Twitch's shirtless policy, necessarily. Actually, I could probably turn on the lights and show it to you briefly with it. Actually, I can do that real quick. Hold on. 1 second. Let me grab the lights. I can show you a little more detail. So, bear with me for half a second, guys. Oops, as I trip over stuff in my office here. So, essentially what it is so there's a heart rate monitor, which actually I think... I should still... Aha, I do. Good. I knew I still had an extra... So what I'm wearing essentially is this. I actually ended up going out and buying a couple extra ones a while back, alongside the ones that Erin sent me. So what I'm actually wearing is this. So it goes around basically right above, or pretty much right below your rib cage here. And so you put it on there, and then there's a little USB stick that comes with it as well that hooks up to the device. It's legit game related, right? Yeah. And so you hook it up to the computer with it, and it actually senses your heartbeat variability. And then the big thing too is because it's mostly used for when you're running around or like doing, it's used for people that run and whatnot to monitor their heart. It's used to having more of a moisture between it, so you got to wet the contacts to make sure they work. I found an interesting solution that works very well, which Erin, I don't know if I'll tell anybody with it, but if you put a thin piece of paper towel between it that's wet, it seems to work for a much longer time than just wetting the general contacts. I was worried that it would mess up the heartbeat, but I did a couple tests on my own and it seemed to not have an issue. I was kind of impressed with that. So that's what I'm wearing under here right now with it. And then that's being brought into the game. And then I can also show you. So then there's this. So it's got this whole calibration set that goes through. And you can actually kind of see it. I hope the numbers are a little bit off. My heartbeat should not be that high. Then again, who knows? I'm not exactly in the best of shape. So I'll take that as it is. But so, Adrian, that's basically what's going on. That's what I'm wearing to basically interact with the game. It's not required. The game does play without it. It's not an acquired feat. It's more just an enhancement to the game. One of the things that's kind of cool, and I was really, really hoping to be able to show, but I wasn't able to really get my hands on it as quick as I'd like, is their partnership recently with Intel. They also do stuff with the new Real 3D Sense camera. I've looked into what it can do, and it's freaking mind-blowing. It's kind of cool. The camera itself is pretty awesome. I was hoping to get a laptop with it to actually showcase for it. I was not able to in time, but I am actually talking with Intel right now, and they might be sending me the dev kit, which would let me actually hook it up and show you guys that. If I do get that, I will make a separate video with that to showcase how the RealSense camera works. And in that case, you wouldn't need the sensor. It actually does everything it needs to do without having kind of stuff hooked up to it. They've got a lot of this information on their website, which I'll be sure to post towards the middle of the stream in the chat, as well as it'll be on the video when we throw it up on YouTube as well. So hopefully that answers your question, Adrian. I'm going to go shut the lights back off, so 1 second. Yeah, it's a very cool, and the whole technological idea was very nice. It's a neat concept. They were very creative, I think, in trying to pursue it. And it's really turned into an awesome game, which is even better. All right, now that they've been moving around, try to let this thing relax a bit. I really don't like that pony thing. Why is there a little wooden pony? It's just not nice. Oops. Uh-huh. And those are going to go out now, too. Of course. Because everybody loves being in darkness. Window release, Adrian, I don't know for sure. It is in early access right now. So you can actually pick it up on Steam if you're interested. They do it. They just released today for early access. And picking up the sensor yourself, like the Garmin sensor, I think I just checked, was about $35 on Amazon. So it's really not that expensive. If you want to do it, like I said, the game works really well on its own anyways without it. Oddly enough, you bring that up, I see, about a VR system. They are working on trying to get this into the Oculus Rift. I know that was part of their original goals a while back when they did their initial Kickstarter. I don't know where that's landing currently, if they're still going to do that or not, but I know that was part of their goals, and I agree. VR and this would be insane. And really, really mean. I do like how the environment keeps changing, too, because I'm pretty sure I'm going back ways that did not exist before. I'm actually really kind of impressed by that. Oh, God. Oh, man. Right, Adrian? And this is just like the tutorial section, too. Just keep that in mind for a minute, too. By the way, Erin, I don't know if you're still in the stream and watching or not, but if you happen to know when the projected release is or if any of the information is public. The projected full release, I'm guessing, is what Adrian was wondering. Oh my God, what in the heck is this? Right gun? Well, that reminds me of a funny comic that came out when they were doing the Kickstarter for this game, which was how to cheat at Nevermind, was to put the heart monitor over a watermelon. It was a hilarious comic, and every time I play this game, I think about that. Okay, I see lights over here, which makes me think there's something. Maybe not. The same as this was? It is, isn't it? Okay. Alright, let's try this way. Oh, I found an item. Ah, there you go. Why darkness? Why can't this be filled with butterflies and ponies? That's my suggestion for future updates. Replace all the scary stuff with butterflies and ponies. Be much nicer. Oh my god. Oh, come on, am I trapped? No. Okay, good. Here's a path. I'm like... Oh, no, that's where I just put... Darn it! Oh, bugger. Just got the other way to go here. It's just furnace to furnace? Yeah, right on Halloween. I just thought of that too, though. I do like kind of the symbolism right now with the idea that she talked about she thought her house was burning down. Oh, God. My sensor just went crazy. Oh, God. part of it might be me moving too. I might be killing the context a little bit. I'm curious what it shows my. Yeah, if I'm jumping that low. I might have to turn the sensitivity down a bit for it. Let's see. Alright, can't interact with that. Oh, I can't see. I want a flashlight. Dead. The game's currently sitting at $25 in early access. I'm not sure how that'll relate to the full price with it. But they've got two episodes going right now with it. And, I mean, honestly, I really wish... I think one of these times I might do a comparison video, if it's all right with Erin, between the academic version and this one. Because, seriously, if you see the differences between the old one and the new one, you'll really understand where that money went. Oh my god. My sensor just went crazy. Doing wrong. I gotta be missing something I gotta pick up or interact with. It's not that. Oh, I don't like the feeling of being trapped. I swear to God, I feel like this nightmare is personally tailored to me right now. My God. The only thing missing are snakes. Which I swear to God, if snakes start falling from the sky now, I'm done. Alright, what am I missing here? Ah. Let me part of why I think the sensor slipped off a little bit there. Circling around. Oh my god. I am so bad at this, you guys. Oh, wait. No, here's something new. Haha. There we go. The house was a trap. Children would be cooked and eaten there. Oh my god. You guys are dark. Uh-huh. Shaky bridge. Oh, God. And now you guys understand why you'll never see a video of me playing Outlast. All right, come on. Be brave, be brave. I know, right there, yeah, that's what I was thinking too, the Hansel and Gretel thought process, jeez. The lack of visibility in this just creates an unnerving atmosphere. Ah, here's another one. She would take us to the forest to die, but would leave a trail to find her way back home. This is Hansel and Gretel. Oh my goodness. That's your first patient, guys. You're in the mind of Hansel and Gretel. Oh my god, I'm not moving. It's moving me. Oh, that's just mean. Bringing it down, bringing it down. I see a helpful sign. What in the hell? It is Hansel and Gretel. Look at that. That is so cool.
When your consciousness is in another subconsciousness, your psyches will inevitably intermingle. Just as the client's mind can affect you, you will see parts of yourself reflected in the mind of the client. Tread lightly and tread carefully.
Oh, what the hell does that mean? Is this game reading my mind now? Dang. I knew technology was impressive, but... Well, part of the advantage of this gun is that it teaches you to overcome kind of that fear, since you have to kind of push through on your own. I'm hoping to use this as a training element for me to be able to actually beat Outlast, finally. Alright, static, clear away, thank you. Mabayid. Oh god, really? Oh man. Alright, I gotta turn on the sensitivity of that a little bit, because I'm just... I can't see too often. I want to, because, like, as much as I'm not good at horror games, I like pushing myself a little bit. There we go. That way I can actually see what I'm doing. Ah, open around, okay. Nothing up here, is there? Oh, no, there's another path, okay. Right. You and I should do a multi-stream gun on that, then. That'd be hilarious. Oh, frickin' A, those are knives. Ha ha ha. I want one to defend myself. God. Huh.
At Neurostalgia, we take great measures to ensure our neuroprobers' safety as best we can. However, you are about to proceed through to a highly dangerous area that you must face alone. If the client's subconscious becomes too volatile, you will be automatically removed from this area of the mind and taken to a safer area of the mind. Use this as an opportunity to collect yourself. When you're ready, you will be able to easily return to where you left off to battle the darkness and chaos that has taken root in the client's subconscious.
Oh, I'm looking forward to this. Hey, Mikey. I was bitten by an animal in my sleep. Interesting. Oh my god, look at like how they're like spikes in the chocolate chips, too. Ha ha ha. Alright, here goes nothing. What the hell? Jeez. Keep guessing numbers, by the way, guys. Oh, yes, N for Mac. I'm sorry, my bad. I forgot about that, too. Oh, my God. There's gotta be a pattern to this. Outside, out, inner, outside. Oh my god. I'm so gonna get dead. I just clicked on that randomly. Oh my goodness. It was the worst birthday ever, obviously. I'm on top of a giant animal. That is awesome. Now I get what all those things were. Oh, that's cool. I just noticed that now. I'm retarded. Right, Mikey? God! Music's mean. Alright, keep myself calm. I don't want to lose this. Yeah! We were lost, but we found a house that looked nice. Nice. I think that might be all of them. Hold on, we'll check the board here. Has nobody won the giveaway yet? Yep, that is all of them. Cool. Watch with my luck, Nightbot's not working. There we go. Okay, I'm like, go on. Alright, Beersy, you get the first one. Like, God, how does nobody get the number yet? Oops, sorry guys, I didn't mean to muck the mouse. Alright, I got you marked down here, Beersy, as the first winner. And then Beersy gets kicked out for caps. Nice. Alright guys, we do have more keys to give away later. Duh. So freaking creepy. Why does he keep doing that? So we do have more keys we'll give away later as well. So if you didn't win now, you got a chance to win later. Alright, let's see if we can put this in order here, guys. Who remembers the story of Hansel and Gretel? Which, see, now I'm not wondering, I'm trying to figure out, is Hansel and Gretel, was that the trick? Is that actually what happened? I don't know. Alright, we got the house was a trap. Children would be cooked. Cooked and eaten there. She would take us to the forest to die, but we leave a trail to find our way back home. Bitten by an animal in my sleep. Worst birthday ever. We were lost, but found a house that looked nice. We'd often eat rabbit stew. My stepmother hated my twin sister and me. Saved me from becoming dinner. Birds would never sing for us. Terrible fire burned our home down. Oh, man. No problem, Beersy. Oh, shoot. Haha, you're right. My bad. Good catch there, Anne, as I was bringing up the website to check something there. My bad. I was wondering what the heck that sound was. It didn't make any sense. My bad, guys. Well, that had a nice background atmosphere to it. That was great. Brilliant on my part there. Probably gonna be totally wrong here. Except mother hated my twin sister and me. If she gets a force to die, you're lost. We lost, but we found a house that looked nice. Oh, that's just creepy. Oh, that's just mean. I knew I'd be wrong. Alright. I'm gonna start with that one again, though. Again, like I said, I don't know if the Hansel and Gretel thing is supposed to be the trick, or if that's, like, the actual story. And if it is, I don't remember Hansel and Gretel that well, which is depressing, but... seem to fit anything. We'd often eat rabbit stew. Oh, did I dead? Like I said, I don't actually remember it that well, which is sad. Oops. I think I skipped it here, Lynn. Bottom Mimble's bitten by my animal in my sleep. Hated my twin sister and me, she was forced to die, time we got very lost. Lost found a house that looked nice. House is a trap, children be cooked and eaten there. Haha, that's right. Okay, there we go. Yeah! Holy blinding light. And now you get to hear the breakthrough. Cool, so I'll sit back and let you guys watch this.
Oh my god, it's all rushing back to me. It's so awful, and I don't want to remember, but... yes, I now know the face of my demon. My sister and I, we were taken out into the woods by my stepmother for one of her nighttime walks. We'd usually find our way back by leaving a trail of whatever we could grab before the walk, marbles, pieces of paper, even pebbles. However, one night, she took us deep, deep into the woods. We brought some bread to leave a trail of crumbs, but all the forest creatures must have eaten them. We were lost, so lost. We tried to find our way back, but it was so dark, and we were in a very strange part of the woods. We were lost for days, hungry and tired. We finally found a house, and we were so hopeful that someone might be able to help us. That house, though, that house was no ordinary house. It looked like candy, and there was something off about it. We shouldn't have gone in, but, well, we did. It was a prison for lost children, like us. There was a woman in the house who would fatten her prisoners up and try to eat them. And that was going to be our fate. I was first. She tricked me into getting close to the oven, and before I knew it, I was inside. Oh, if it weren't for my clever sister Gretel pulling me out in time, I would have been burned alive.
That was the hand. Okay.
We escaped that house and found our way home. After that, things started to get better. Our awful stepmother passed away, and my family came into some wealth. I guess we just forgot about those events. I mean, how could you live with those images and memories inside your mind? Then again, they were always there. The old woman still torturing us beyond memory, beyond time. However, I can now confront my past, confront this trauma. It is better to know than not to know.
Nice. So the tutorial simulator was Hansel and Gretel. I like that. That's good. Okay. You guys get credit for me on that, guys. It was good. Hey, Cedric, man, welcome to the stream. We just completed up actually the tutorial section here for the first part of the game. We're going to go into the second part as well in a second. See, okay, you're the third person to say that now. That is so weird. Erin, I don't know if you're still in here or not with it, but that's like three people now that have thought I was the one narrating. That's kind of creepy. Did you guys steal my voice and didn't even tell me? I'm flattered, but I mean, you know, I could have done a much better job if I knew you were actually using me. Okay, those are the future ones. Cool. Okay, cool. So this is actually the one from the very... See, I wish I got paid for voiceover work. All right, cool. So this will be the next one we'll do here then. So this is the... If I'm seeing the visuals right, I think this is the one that was from the original Academic and everything with it. So I had actually seen this one, which is kind of cool. But I have not seen it in all of its glory yet.
I guess I don't know where to start. Anywhere? Okay. Well, I've been a real estate agent for the past 20 years. I graduated from a small college, just about half an hour from here, actually. I've never been married. I have no siblings. I've always loved cats. I hate churches. I guess I've always been a little bit of a loner. I really hate how people look at me. Especially lately. I've honestly felt pretty, I don't know, normal. Until about a couple of years ago, after my mother's death. That was when things started to come apart. Do you ever feel like people are just staring at you? Like when you walk into a room and everyone knows something they're not telling you? I don't know, I just feel awful when I'm around people, guilty, angry at... I had a pretty happy childhood. My dad passed away when I was just a kid. My mother told me that he died in a car accident. I don't remember that day, though. Maybe I was too young. My dad and I always played drinks. He was a businessman. I remember him.
Thanks for the follow, man. Appreciate it.
Family finances. My mom and I were never all that close, but I do miss her. She loved her wine. Lord, I don't know why this is happening to me. I was the perfect little girl.
No such thing as a perfect little girl. I call shenanigans on that. Yep, okay, cool. So this is the original level with it. Cool. I'm looking forward to seeing this all redesigned. Having a tea party, it was so hot that day. Not enough, I don't actually remember all the story of it. Wow, does this look awesome. Just take a second, guys, and just appreciate the design of this. That is just so cool. Welcome to a game that's supposed to be the inner psyche, where you can pretty much design anything you want. Huh. I hear a puppy. Of course, the game's gonna start all nice and happiness, and then it's gonna get all dark and evil. Oh. Aw, it's a cute teddy bear! I want to take him with me. Oh, I can't. Come on, why can't you guys let me take the teddy bear with me? Game's scary enough as is. let me bring the teddy with. Ugh, who decorated this room? Man. I apologize if it was you, Erin. Whoa, this room looks new. Whoa. Yeah, I definitely need to do some side-by-side comparisons between this and the original academic version. You guys just have to see how much has changed in all this. You have no idea how mind-blowing it is having played the academic version and playing this. It's just so cool to see. Family games and puzzles. To make you feel at ease before the game decides to be like, Mwahaha! I have actually played a little bit of The Evil Within, Mikey. I'm debating taking a week and doing a bunch of scary games, doing Let's Plays of, like, Outlast. I'd love to go back and replay The Original Amnesia and do Evil Within and stuff like that. I don't think I can handle that. Oh. Whoa, anybody else noticing the shift of perspective here? I didn't even pick that up until just now. I'm small. Huh. How have you guys realized that? Now look at the door where the handle is, and think about where the handle is on you when you're standing. I'm small. I didn't realize that until just now, actually. Interesting. Okay, let's look if there's anything specific in here. I like that idea, Gun, actually. I think that'd be a lot of fun. Gotta make this realistic, like every little kid. Mom! Mom! But Mom! But Mom! Okay, I'm done. Okay, is this going anywhere otherwise, too? Right, Gun. I want milk. Aww. Ooh, let me play with the knives. Let me play with the knives. Aww. Darn this game being safe and proper. Can I turn off the music? No, I can't even do that, can I? Fine. Alright, time to head upstairs. See? Now all that niceness and happiness just goes to evilness now.
Turn the lights off and go to sleep, honey.
Wow. Yeah, this looks so different that I don't remember any of this. Actually, just very vaguely remember any of it. To see the dark... You must kill the light. Ha ha ha. What? Oh my god. God, about the gunshot. Oh, I wonder, okay. Can I put these? Haha! Right, Gun? I know! Holy crap. I think I'm starting to remember part of the story. Not a ton, though. Oh, I feel like there's been blood drops in the cup, too. That'd been great. It'd be really, really nice, you know, nightmare-inducing stuff. Oops. Ah. Fail on my part there. It's okay, they're just cups. I'm scared what's gonna happen though. Oh, hey, look at that, a picture. Mommy's favorite drink was grown-up grape juice. Oh, that's good. Whoa. Love, money, sorrow. Tea. Tree, shower, milk, fruit, gun, car. Oh, God. Oh, there's clues in here somewhere. Oh, man, what is it now? That which has been left behind... That which lies before you can be realized through that which has been left behind you. Ha 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 ha! Ha 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 ha! Alright, we got three pictures and three items in there. I like it. Alright, middle one's gun. What is that farm? I remember farm being one of the options. I gotta look at that again. Alright, middle one's gun. I figured that much out. What are my options? Okay, maybe the last one's love? Or is that last one sorrow? Tree. No. Maybe the last one's supposed to be sorrow? Shower. Oh. Ha ha, milk. Because it was a cow. Ha 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 ha. I am so bad at this. Daddy and his letters. He never wanted to play after the mailman brought new ones. It is on Steam, actually, man. That's actually what I'm playing on right now. This is Nevermind on Early Access on Steam. The game's called Nevermind, like I said. You can find it for $25 right now on Early Access. And if you stick around otherwise, though, we do have some giveaways. We have some copies we can give away as well. I'm going to try to give away at least one more in the stream. If we get a couple more viewers, I might give away more. We'll see. Well, this definitely wasn't like this before. That bloodstain, my God. This isn't freaky, not at all. Oh, that's just the whole design, oh my God. Ooh, another picture. Mommy always waved goodbye to Daddy when he drove to work. Aw, that's sweet. Whoa. Bathe in woes. But Mom, there's blood outside your door. It's kind of creepy. Oh my God. Okay, I gotta get myself calm now. Oh my goodness. Holy creepy Batman. Ah! Well, that doesn't seem normal. Is that induced by my fear? I think it might be. Yep, it's currently on Early Access on Steam. Died in a car accident. She was sad. She hated questions about it. Oh my goodness. If you stick around for a bit otherwise, too, man, I will I'll link the article we wrote up about this game. It gives you a little more information kind of about what it's all about. White as bone. Oh, ha ha ha. Bathe in woes. Now that is a lot of milk, I tell you.
Get your own damned milk!
Oh my god. Why does it look like bodies? That's just creepy. I don't think it should still be moving. I don't like it moving. Oh, why is it moving? That's not cool. Don't move. Stop moving. I want a fridge this big. Oh my god, with the moving and the things and the... Why is it moving? Oh my god. Oh, and of course it's dead end. What does it say on the... Hold on. They know what you have done. Pour yourself a cup, delicious and perfect for a late afternoon drink after playing tea party with your toys. Just don't spill me. That would make them hurt themselves, isn't that right? Why did you have to spill me? Why did you have to make mommy and... This is just horrible. This game needs a disclaimer. Nobody under the age of, like, 50 should play this thing. Because it's terrifying and nightmare-inducing. I am not sleeping well tonight. My god, I can just tell. And now you understand the name of the game, because everything makes you go, never mind! Happy home milk. Oh my god, look at the nutritional facts. Total fault, 100%. They know, 100%. Your fault, 100%. Oh my goodness. The early access cost is 25 right now. So it's 25, you get two levels for it with the potential for two more coming out, I believe. I know they have plans to release a lot more as well. There's something back here. Okay, that's just not cool, stop it. The attention to detail on here is very, very good. Wow, where is the bloody exit to this maze? I think I just circled around there. Yeah, I did. Brilliant. Brilliant, I tell myself. Nope, nothing back over there. Nope, not that way either. Oh my god, I'm like a frickin' rat in a maze here. The worst rat in a maze ever. I'm the idiot rat that never finds the cheese. Oh my god. So glad I'm doing this live on stream too. Make myself look like an idiot. Which way didn't I go yet? Oh my lord, I'm just bad at this. Oh wait a minute, I don't think I saw this. That's the door I came in, isn't it? Of course it is. Damn it. Oh my god. Yeah, whatever you don't look up, right? My god. That just circles around. That dead ends there. Okay. Do. Alright, sooner or later, through process of elimination, I'm gonna get out of this damn thing. It has to be down this way. I had to just miss something down here. Somebody might have been hiding something. Oh my god. Oh, here we go. This is something new. Aha! Mom and Dad were never home. It was pretty lonely. Yeah, unfortunately, yeah, that's the reason you can't change the qualities because we're not partnered. Hopefully someday. That is the hope and goal. Alright, we got the picture, so now do I back out of here? Is there another exit? I wonder. Ah, there's a door over here. Okay, cool. I want to get the hell out of here as quick as possible. My god. Oh my goodness. Shouldn't have to keep buffering every 2 seconds. That might be a connection issue on your side. It's unfortunate, but...
I'm busy!
Of course you're still busy. You're always busy!
Did you pay this?
I did my best.
How late are
you? I have it under control!
What?
Okay, that's creepy. What's moving? What the... God! Okay. So glad I'm wearing the heartbeat monitor right now. Totally loving that. I don't want to proceed now. I'm scared to proceed. I see puzzle pieces. You're going to turn around on me, aren't you? Like, you know what's going to happen. Yeah, that's not creepy. Nope, totally not. Do I have all the pieces? I don't know if I do. Let's see if I have all the pieces first. I do not.
Oh.
Oh. Cedric, this should be running at 60 FPS. Or at least that's what my computer can do. I don't really know what the game itself runs at, actually. I'm gonna get... That wasn't happening, I just know it. Oh. Oh, damn. Oh, that's just not cool. So there's the failure criteria, and I got freaked out either a little too much or too many screams. I'm not sure now. Son of a gun. Oh, that is so freaky. Oh my god. Well, you know what? This actually may work out kind of well. Nice gun. Actually, I'll leave it. So that actually kind of works out kind of well, because here's what I'm going to do. Because I know a lot of you guys are showing interest in this game and you want to play it. What I don't want to do is I don't want to spoil it for everybody. So despite the fact that I know a lot of you would like to see the conclusion of this one, I'm actually going to stop here. We may do some more down the line if we can get more viewers with it. But I do want to thank everyone that did show up for the stream. I encourage you guys to go check out the game. It is a very, very good game. Again, you can find it on Steam for $25. Well, excuse me. Or we are going to do one more giveaway with it for now. Hey, birds, I'm talking. Leave me alone. That's just weird. That's just annoying. So we're going to do one more giveaway here in just a second here. I will do that in just a small bit. But seriously, guys, check out this game. Check out a lot of their stuff with it as well. Let me get the giveaway started here. So if you've never done the giveaway, some of you should have seen it earlier. But the giveaway is extremely simple to do. What it's going to do is Nightbot's going to pick a random number. And what you have to do is keep typing in that number until you get it. So Nightbot's picked one. You just basically type in the number and you go for it. Whoever gets the right number will win the copy. So while you guys are doing that, I want to once again thank everyone for tuning into this stream. I especially want to thank Erin for showing up. I really appreciate you coming and showing your support for us running this through it. As you guys can see, again, this game is called Nevermind. Like I said, you can find it on Steam for $25 with it. Beyond that, I will post up in a second here. There are quite a few. We've done quite a few different articles on this game as well, all throughout the history, actually, of the game. I'm going to pause those damn birds. We've actually done a lot of history in the game all the way back to when we first talked to Erin back in February or March of last year. There's a lot of cool information about it. So if you guys are new to the stream, please hit that follow button. Show your support for the stream. I really appreciate everyone showing up for it. We do try to do a lot more as we go along. I'm going to have a beast with it. Hey, congratulations, IC. Looks like you are the winner for it. We try to do a lot more streams of that. We are going to be kicking up our stream stuff a little bit more as well, and I definitely want to stream more of this. If you liked what you saw as well, let us know, because we'd like to kind of know what you want to see. Otherwise, guys, I am known as the Red Gamer. I am the current CEO and founder of Urban Gaming Elite. Please check us out at urbangamingelite.com. We do plenty of different unique gaming content, articles, different pieces with it, including indie spotlights on great indie developers, including Erin Reynolds, who was the main developer behind this game. Go check out that indie spotlight. She is a lovely person to talk to. Very, very energetic and fun, and apparently really messed up in the head to make this game, I swear. If you guys didn't get a chance to catch the whole stream, we will be uploading this on YouTube. As soon as this is done, it pre-records and everything onto my computer. I will be getting my video person to basically try to edit and put it together extremely quick. To basically kind of put everything together and try to get it up very quick so you can see what we have with it as well. With that, guys, that's pretty much all I have. Thanks again for everyone that showed up. Check us out at urbangamingelite.com. Make sure you follow, and we'll see you guys next time.